Namaskar, student. Today we are going to start new topic. Means this one is chapter 9, and this is the revision part, and this is numerical from this chapter, and this is part 82. So this is our first numerical. Calculate the value of stress in a wire of steel having a radius of 2 millimeter of 10 kilonewton of force is applied on it. So F equals to 10 kilonewton equals to 1 into 8th power 4 newton, and R is radius. R that 2 millimeter equals to 2 into 8th power minus 3 meter. So A equals to, we know that pi r square, so we have to put the values, and which is equivalent to 12.56 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square. So stress, which is equivalent to force by area, and we have to put the values, and the value is 7.696 into 10 to the power 8 newton per meter square. This is problem number 2 or question number 2. Consider a steel rod having radius of 8 millimeter and the length of 2 meter in a force of 150 kilonewton stretches it along its length. So then calculate the stress and percentage of strain in the rod if the elongation in length is 7.46 millimeter. So radius is given, length is given, and force is given. So area A equals to pi r square, which is pi into 8 into 10 to the power minus 3, that total whole square. So it is equivalent to 201 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square. So 201, this is into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square. So what is the stress? Force by area, we have to put the values, and which is equivalent to 7.46 into 10 to the power 8 newton per meter square. Longitudinal strain del L by L, which is equivalent to 3.73 into 10 to the power minus 3, and what is the percentage strain? It is equivalent to 0.37%. This is question number 3. If the angle of shear is 30 degree for a cubical body and the change in length is 250 centimeter, then what must be the volume of the cubical body? So here the angle of shear, which is equivalent to 30 degree, and length change in length, which is del L, equals to 2.5 meter. So what is shear strain? It is equivalent to tan theta equals to del L by L, which is equivalent to 2.5 divided by L, so tan 30 degree. So what is the value of L? This is 2.5 divided by tan 30 degrees. So it is equivalent to 2.5 divided by 0.577 equals to 4.332 meter. So V equals to L cube, which is equivalent to 81.309 meter cube. This is question number 4. A steel cable with a radius of 1.5 centimeter supports a shear lift at a sky area. If the maximum stress is not to exceed 10 to the power 8 newton per meter square, then what is the maximum load that the cable can support? So here R, the value of R is given. So the maximum stress is already given, that 10 to the power 8 newton per meter square. So area of cross section of steel cable, which is pi R, equals to pi R square. So 3.14 into 1.5 into 10 to the power minus 2, that whole square or meter square. So it is equivalent to 3.14 into 2.25 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter square. So what is the maximum stress? It is equivalent to maximum force into area of cross section. So maximum force equals to maximum stress into area of cross section, which is equivalent to 10 to the power 8 into 3.14 into 2.25 into 10 to the power minus 4 newton, and it is equivalent to 7.1 into 10 to the power 4 newton. Question number 5 is given. A wire of length 2.5 meter has a percentage strain of 0.012% under a tensile force. So determine the extension in the wire. So L is 2.5 meter, so strain del L by L, which is equivalent to 0.012 divided by 100. So del L equals to strain into L, which is equivalent to del L means 0.012 divided by 100 into L. So it is equivalent to 0.3 millimeter. Question number 6. if the square of length 4 meter and cross sectional area is 2 meter square is stretched by a force of 3 kN, determine the change in length due to its force. So Young modulus of materials of wear 110 into 9 newton per meter square is given. So F is the area of the cross section A equals to 2 meter square and force F equals to 3 kN, which is 3 into 10 to the power 3 newton, and L is given that this is equivalent to 4 meter. So what is the Young modulus, is y equals to fl divided by a del l. So del l equals to fl by ay. So we have to put the values, and after calculating the values we get that 54.5 into 10 to the power minus 3 millimeter. Question number 7. A material having Poisson ratio 0.2, a load is applied on it due to its upper longitudinal strain 3 into 10 to the power minus 3. So find out the percentage change in its volume. So Poisson ratio, which is equivalent to 0.2, so longitudinal strain del L by L, which is equivalent to 3 into 10 to the power minus 3. So here what is the expression of Poisson ratio, which is equivalent to minus del D by D divided by del L by L. So del R by R equals to, and also minus del R by R divided by del L by L. So this is from the definition. We know that this is from, means we can obtain this is from the definition. So del R by R equals to what? Minus that Poisson ratio into del L by L. So which is equivalent to minus 0.6 into 10 to the power minus 3. So we have to find the volume, which is pi r square L. So we have to derivative both sides. So percentage change in volume, which is equivalent to del V by V into 100 equals to del R by R plus del L by L into 100. So we have to put the values, and after calculating the value, it is equivalent to 0.18%. So this is all about my today's topic. Tomorrow I will going to start another topic, means another numerical from this chapter. So thank you, student, for watching this video.